Hello, and today we are proposing you a follow-up on a project that we've been covering almost since its inception, and that is the revolutionary balance wheel developed by Dominique Renault, known as the Blade Resonator, where the regular balance wheel is replaced by a blade-like system, in fact, two opposing blades that are forming a super small hinge, taking over the role of the pivots. So Mr. Dominique Renault is a genius and master watchmaker whom some of you probably know when he was at the helm with his partner Giulio Papi of Renault Papi, one of the most important and significant and creative watch movement development company of the last decades. This company was bought by Audemars Piguet already a little while ago and is now known as APRP, and they have been working on a very important number of movements that you will not only find in AP watches but also for the likes of Richard Mille, HYT, IWC. Well, there are many, many examples of how this pure brain power capabilities have been used in some extraordinary watches. So Mr. Giulio Papi continued with the company, whereas Mr. Dominique Renault took a bit of time off, so to speak, but his heart remained the one of a master watchmaker. So when a few years back he announced his return on the scene, well, we were all delighted by it, and we knew that it wouldn't be for a simple reason. So he's been working on a totally new and challenging new approach to how the regulation of a watch functions. And instead of using the good old balance wheel and its spiral, the goal of his resonator blade system is to significantly increase the performance of how a watch functions while remaining a beautiful mechanical object to look at and enjoy. So with a regular balance wheel, something that impacts the precision of a watch is the fact that this wheel is held by pinions. Therefore, there is a lot of friction happening at both ends of this mechanism. So to reduce this friction, you can reduce the size of the pinions, of course, but you can only do so to a certain extent. If they are too small, well, they can break, and then it defies any purpose of this so-called performance enhancement. So a few years back, Breguet came out with a system where one end of the pinion would be held by magnetism. So there has been a few endeavors, but this one shown today for the very first time is a real milestone. Okay, this system is still nevertheless in its early development stage, but the previous versions we had seen were either big mock-ups or some prototypes working on adapted existing movements. But today, it's the first time that we see the entire full mechanism working independently and being manufactured only solely for the purpose of this movement. So you have to realize that this is a very small team that is working on this, and it just can't be compared, for instance, with what we showed you with the Simon escapement seen in the Zenith DeFi lab. I mean, the means are just not comparable, and what they've achieved in less than 3 years with this this small workshop is just remarkable. But let's listen to the man himself, who will give us some additional info on this achievement.
Le but c'est de trouver un facteur qualité plus important. Donc ce couteau, il permet de travailler avec le fil de la lame, même s'il y a un micro-diamètre qui est toujours existant, qui est de l'ordre entre 1 et 2 centièmes. Le but, c'est d'avoir un facteur qualité important pour pouvoir que l'organe régulateur soit plus libre. Et s'il est plus libre, on va gagner en chronométrie et en réserve de marche. Alors bien sûr qu'il y a tout un travail encore à faire derrière. On a pu valider le principe. Mais derrière, il faut faire des affûtages, peut-être des matériaux, peut-être de la céramique. Mais de faire fonctionner déjà actuellement ce mouvement avec un couteau en acier affûté à la main, où on n'a aucune connaissance arriérée sur le principe, je suis vraiment content et je trouve que c'est déjà un exploit. Et en tout cas, grâce à toute mon équipe.
So on our side, we started our Patreon campaign to help us finance our activity, and in a certain way, what the Dominique Renault team are a bit doing kind of the same by asking patrons to help them out, but with a much larger check than us, of course. So the idea is that they will produce only 12 pieces like the one presented today, but you can customize it as you want, and they are asking 1 million Swiss francs for this. I know it may sound completely crazy, well, actually, it is a bit, but you are not really buying buying a watch through this. I mean, instead, they claim that you are giving them a means that will help them propose and develop solutions to the benefit of the entire watch industry. And we can definitely trust Dominique Renaud of having still many creative ideas in his head. So of course, I like the thought process, but I don't really know what to think about it because, I mean, those are pretty serious patrons you need to find at this level. But I guess here there are some. And there has been actually one in Geneva, so I mean, bravo to him. I think that was pretty audacious. So anyhow, I mean, the system is just brilliant. It still needs some further development to make it a thorough mechanical reality. And I really hope that the journey will continue for them after having presented this incredible machine. I know that some of you may think that the design is quite special, but here the idea is really to have developed something where you can see from all angles, I mean, this very disruptive take on mechanical watchmaking. So if you want to know more, I mean, I clearly invite you to see the two previous video reports we had done about the Dominique Renaud. I mean, it's one on demand because, I mean, his curriculum is just very impressive. And the other one where he explains us the roots and the genesis of this project. So I hope you enjoyed this one and all the best and see you real soon.